Before starting this video, I would like to give a shout out to my friends over at glazeding.com. These guys have one of the best tempered glasses in India. Their 2.5D real curved glass is one of the best that I've ever used on a smartphone, and they have it for the Mi A3 as well. All of my phones have their real curved glasses and I'm really happy with the quality, and that is something you don't easily get in India. So do check out glazeding.com and don't forget to use the promo code Gizmo to save 10% on your order. Hey guys, Gizmodict here, and today we're going to check out Google Camera on the Xiaomi Mi A3. So the Mi A3, unlike the previous Mi A series devices, does come with camera to API enabled right out of the box. So it's very easy to install Gcam on it. And the best part about this phone is that Google Camera is very, very compatible with this phone. In fact, if I talk about all of the recent phones that I've tested with Google Camera, like the Redmi Note 7 Pro, K20 Pro, K20, and even the flagships like the OnePlus 7, Google Camera has actually been the most compatible on the Xiaomi Mi A3. So yeah, today let's find out how good Google Camera is on this phone, and if you guys have the Mi A3, you've got to install this on your phone. So without wasting any more time, let's get started. Let's take a look at all of those samples. And if you guys don't want to miss such videos in the future, make sure that you subscribe to the channel and you also press the bell icon. I'm also making this video in Hindi, so if you want a link to that you'll also get in the video's description. Now let's get started with the video. Okay, first of all, we need to install the Google Camera APK, and I will be linking the one that I'm using in the video's description. So go to the link given below, download the APK, and then install it on your phone. Once you install the APK, open it, and here you need to go to settings and change a couple of things. I'll walk you through them right now. Okay, so once you're in the settings menu, first of all, you need to go to this option which says HDR Enhanced Auto White Balance from Pixel 2 or Pixel 3. And make sure that this is turned to off, because otherwise the white balance gets messed up, so just keep it to off. Then click on Advanced, go to Base, and here you need to change the config to Pixel 2018 ZSLR HDR Plus. Then you need to go to the front camera model and you need to change it to Nexus 6P. Then you need to go down to the libraries and here select Xlib 2.3. You can also use the GMM23B library that's given. You can try out both of them, and whichever you like more, you can go with that. I'm gonna go with Xlib 2.3. And then below that, you need to click on Use Pixel 3 Color Transform, keep it on, and then you need to relaunch the app. After that, under the photo settings, click on Advanced, and here you need to click on Resampling Method to Riser, and the final JPEG quality should be 100%. You can also play around with the zoom settings in the portrait mode if you want to, but that's pretty much it. These are the settings that you're supposed to change, and after that you can just start clicking photos with Google Camera on your Mi A3. So now let's talk about the photo quality, and I want to start off with the selfies because this is where I could see the biggest improvement on the Mi A3. So if you take a look at the photos side by side, you can see that the selfies from Google Camera are just amazing. You need to focus on a lot of areas here. So if you see the photo from the stock app, it's very overexposed, the highlights are blown out, and all in all, the selfie is not that pleasing. On the other hand, if you take a look at the photos from Gcam, here the sky is perfectly in the picture, the dynamic range is very good. If you take a look at the skin tones, they look a lot more pleasing as compared to the stock app. And like I said, overall the dynamic range is very good. You can see the sky clearly, you can see everything in the background, the colors are on point, the detailing is very good, and there is no overexposing going on in the Google Camera photo. So yeah, the selfie is just amazing. The portrait mode is also very good. The edge detection might not be as good as the stock app in some photos, but all in all, it's just a very big upgrade in terms of qualities in Gcam as compared to the stock cam. I've tested a lot of phones recently with Google Camera, and with respect to the front-facing camera, I've not seen any other phone this compatible as compared to the Mi A3. Even if I talk about the OnePlus 7, the Redmi Note 7 Pro, K20 Pro, all of those phones have some minor issues in the front-facing camera with respect to saturation or something like that. But the Mi A3 is spot on with its colors, dynamic range and everything, and I really like clicking selfies on this phone. Now I'm waiting to see how can Realme 5 Pro challenge this, because Realme phones are very good at selfies. But yeah, all in all, Google Camera gives a major boost to selfies, and this also works with night sight. So here you can see a selfie taken in the stock app and taken with night sight in Google Camera app. So the selfie performance gets a huge thumbs up from my side, and you guys are gonna love taking selfies on the Xiaomi Mi A3. Now let's move on to the rear facing camera, and here I would like to point out one thing, that as of now the wide angle lens is not working on the Mi A3 in Google camera. I tried playing around with the K20 Pro's G Cam because that had wide angle lens working, but unfortunately that's not working on the Mi A3. So maybe in the future we will have it, but as of now let's just talk about the primary camera, because here also there are a lot of improvements. So yeah, let's take a look at samples from the primary camera. Now here we're going to talk about photos in the daylight first, and here there are a couple of differences with respect to the stock cam and with respect to the Google camera. If you take a look at the photos side by side closely, you can see that stock camera overexposes in a lot of cases. The highlights are majorly overexposed in majority of the photos taken with the stock camera app, and all in all, it doesn't look that great. In comparison, if you check out photos taken from G Cam, these photos have better dynamic range. The highlights are not overexposed in any of the photos, and you can have proper detailing in each and every picture. But then when you zoom in, if you talk about the sharpness or the detailing of the objects, that is better on the stock cam, but Google camera is also not that bad. Especially if you talk about the dynamic range, like I said, even the shadows are better in Google camera in some photos. And the color accuracy is also on point in G Cam as compared to the stock app. So yeah, I do think that Google camera produces slightly better photos in comparison to the stock app, and you should use it when you're clicking photos in broad daylight. Similarly, when we move on to the indoor conditions, the colors once again are better on G Cam, and the dynamic range is also slightly better. The shadows are the major area where Google camera does better, and this is because we are using the XLIP 2.3 in the Google camera app. So that is giving us better shadows, and here the detailing is also not that bad. If you compare it with the stock camera definitely has more details, but then Google camera has less noise. The noise reduction is very good on G Cam, so all in all, I think Google camera once again is slightly better. Especially if you talk about colors, Google camera is very, very consistent with the colors in majority of the lighting scenarios. The stock camera can mess up the colors sometimes, but Google camera is always spot on. So that's one thing that I really liked. Now finally, we'll move on to the low lighting conditions, and here obviously night sight is gonna be better on G Cam as compared to the night mode that we have on the stock app. So when I took photos in low lighting condition outdoors, the difference was not that much, but still Google camera would still pull in more light in a lot of areas in the picture as compared to the stock app. The difference is more evident in the indoor conditions where Google camera performs much better. But here you need to keep two things in mind. First of all, you need to have a very steady hand, because somehow, I don't know, the phone takes more time to click a photo in night sight as compared to the Redmi Note 7 Pro. Probably the Snapdragon 665 is not as fast as the 675 in processing, so that's why there's a slight delay, and because of that you need to hold your phone a second or two longer while clicking a photo. So you have to keep a very stable hand, otherwise you might get a blurry pic. But still, the quality from night sight is much better than what you get with the night mode. Now lastly, coming to the rear facing camera portraits, here once again I love the performance from Google camera. Like the selfies, here also you get better dynamic range, better skin tones, and overall the photo looks much better than what you have on the Mi A3 stock cam. Once again, the edge detection can suffer a bit in some photos on G Cam because it's not gonna use the secondary lens, it's all software, but still I do like the overall output from the Google camera as compared to the stock cam on the Mi A3. So overall, Google camera performs amazingly well on the Mi A3. Like the title says, it's actually magic on this phone, because I haven't seen any other phone this compatible with G Cam recently. If we talk about, let's say, the Redmi Note 7 Pro that's priced similarly with the Mi A3, that phone can give good pictures with G Cam, but then if we talk about the rear facing camera portrait mode, it's better on the stock cam. Even if we talk about the OnePlus 7, 7 Pro or the Asus 6e that I've tested recently, Google camera is not this compatible. It's better in some scenarios, but then in other scenarios, the stock camera performs better on those phones. But the Mi A3 in 100% scenarios, Google camera is better than stock cam, and the performance increases way too much, as you saw, especially in terms of selfies. So personally, I feel that the Mi A3 might just be the best camera phone under 15,000 rupees if you're going to install G Cam on it. So yeah, if you guys were planning to buy this phone, or if you guys want a phone for 13,000 rupees with the best camera performance, go buy the Mi A3 and install Google camera on it. I'm still yet to test the Realme 5 Pro because I really have high expectations with that phone's camera. So once I get it in the first sale, I'll try out with Google camera and see how good that phone performs in comparison to the Mi A3. But as of now, I'm really happy with Mi A3's performance. I'm still testing it out, so a full review would be coming very soon. So if you guys don't want to miss that out, please subscribe to the channel, please press the bell icon, and please like this video and share it with your friends. If you guys have any feedback or opinions about this video, do let me know in the comments, and any questions, please ask me on my Facebook, Twitter and Instagram page. If you need the Google camera link or the tempered glass for the Mi A3, all the links are given in the description box. That's it for now. Thanks for watching, and I'm gonna be back in your notifications very, very soon. Peace.